everyone, Jason here. It has been on my list for a long time to build a LEGO Orrery. And a couple of months ago, I finally sat down and started putting one together. And this is the result. Now, if you don't know what an orrery is, it's just a fancy word for a mechanical model of the solar system or part of the solar system. And in this case, I just decided to focus on the sun, the earth, and the moon, and trying to get their relative rotations and orbital periods fairly accurate without making it overly complicated. And it may look complicated, but trust me, it could have been a lot more complex than it actually is. Before I walk you through the drive system and explain how it all works, let's just take a look at how this model stacks up to real life. Every turn of the crank represents one day, and as you can see, with every full rotation, the Earth also makes one full rotation. The moon in this model rotates around the Earth once every 28 days, which is fairly close to the 27.33 days it takes in real life. In the real world, the sun is actually not a solid object, so its observable rate of rotation varies depending on what latitude you're looking at. But at the equator, it rotates once every 24.47 days, and in this model, I have it set to rotate once every 25 days. And as far as the Earth and the Moon rotating around the Sun goes, in this model it takes 375 days, which is still over 97% accurate to the real 365.256 days that are in each one of our years. Now, the best way to show you how the drive system works is to do it digitally. Here's a model I put together, an LDCad, and the nice thing about this is that I can remove most of the surrounding frame so that you can really see what's going on. And we will start by just taking a look at the gears that drive the rotation of the Earth. I even set up a little animation here so that you can see them in action. One thing to note is that these gears in the middle are what LEGO calls gear wheels. And what's special about them is that they have a smooth hole in their center as opposed to an axle hole. And this allows them to rotate around an axle at a different rate than the axle itself, which will allow the sun to spin more slowly than they do once we add it to the system. Now, let's add the gears driving the moon. There are only a handful of them, and as you can see, they've been added to the end of the main gear system. The moon is connected to the top of a small turntable, which also has a hole running through it, and which again allows the axle rotating the Earth to spin at a different rate than the turntable itself. Next up we have the sun, and as you can see, there are only a few additional gears used to rotate it that come off pretty early on in the main gear train. And finally, we need to rotate the entire upper frame that the Earth and the Moon are connected to. And to do that, we're going to use this large turntable, which also has a hole in its center, allowing the gears and the axle rotating the Earth, Moon, and the Sun to rotate independently of it. And that turntable is driven using these gears that come off the axle rotating the sun, and they actually rotate pretty slowly, so it might be kind of hard to see in this animation. I have created building instructions for this model, which you can find over at jkbrickworks.com, as usual. And as always, thanks for watching, keep on building, and I will see you next time.